FastTrack Schedule 10, there are two scheduling methods that we can use in order to manage how our activities will interact throughout our project. These methods are known as effort-driven and fixed-duration scheduling. With effort-driven scheduling, we say that the amount of work, typically calculated in hours, will always remain constant across the task, as we either increase or decrease the number of resources or change the amount of effort that the resources are applying, the duration will automatically adjust. A good example of effort-driven scheduling would be the setup for a trade show. If the setup requires 8 hours, when we assign a resource to that task, it takes 8 hours of work and therefore 1 day. It takes 1 day because our default working day is set at 8 hours per day. If we double the number of resources, so we assign 2 resources to that task, it will still take a total of 8 hours to finish. However, because the resources can work at the same time, they'll each work 4 hours and 4 hours, that means it will actually cut the duration in half to half of a day. The second scheduling method that we have is known as fixed duration scheduling. With fixed duration scheduling, we say that the duration to finish the task will always remain constant. As we increase or decrease the number of resources or change the amount of effort that a resource applies, the amount of work in hours will automatically adjust to account for this. A good example of fixed duration scheduling would be the trade show itself. If the trade show is 3 days, no matter how many resources we assign to it, it will always occur over 3 days. For example, if we assign 1 resource, the duration is 3 days with a total amount of work of 24 hours. Again, this is because our default day is defined as 8 hours per day. So 8 hours per day times 3 hours gives us 24 hours of work. If we double the number of resources, so if we have 2 resources working during this trade show, it will then double the amount of work. So the duration remains 3 days, however our work increases from 24 to 48 total hours. The default scheduling method in FastTrack is effort-driven. That means as we build our schedules, all activities are automatically created with an effort-driven scheduling and a fixed amount of work. We can at any point in time change what the default method will be for our schedules. To do that, we can go to our FastTrack Schedule 10 icon and Document Options. In Document Options, we'll focus on the lower area labeled Defaults. We'll notice here that Apply Effort-Driven Scheduling when making assignments to bars is currently selected. However, if we'd like to switch our scheduling method so that fixed duration is the default for all newly created tasks, we can do this by deselecting Apply Effort-Driven Scheduling and then selecting Fixed Duration Scheduling. In addition to this, we have an option labeled Ignore Resource Calendars when creating new bars. These items are typically used together because we could say that an activity always occurs over 3 specific days, for example, a Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. If we choose to ignore the resource calendars, if a resource had a day off during that period of time, the activity will still occur over that period. This way, we can always make sure activities occur exactly when they need to, despite any different exceptions that our resources may have. In addition to being able to set the default for your schedule, if you've already built out your schedule in effort-driven but you'd like to change it to fixed duration, you can also do that at any point in time. To do that, we'll remain in this Document Options dialog and select the tab labeled General. At the top, we have options for changing settings on all bars, and we'll select the second option, Change Settings on All Bars. We'll notice here that this says changes cannot be undone, so once we make these changes, we will not be able to switch them back. Below, we have options for all 3 of the scheduling methods, so fixed duration, effort-driven scheduling, or the option to ignore resource calendars. So if we would like to switch over to fixed duration, all we have to do is go to fixed duration, select change all bars to fixed duration, effort-driven scheduling, change all bars to not effort-driven scheduling, and ignore resource calendars, change all bars to ignore resource calendars. Now when we select OK, it will automatically update all existing activities in our project, set them to follow fixed duration scheduling instead of the predefined effort-driven scheduling, and we can continue to plan our project from that point in time. Effort-driven and fixed duration scheduling again will allow us to set up exactly how our activities will function within our project.